Hey, I'm Sam Carr, and I sing for the band Architects. And today, I'm doing What's In My Bag. I actually have a bag as well. That's how sad I am in lockdown life. I've prepared, so I'm actually like I'm at Amoeba. But yeah, I'm going to be going through some of my favourite records. Amoeba is such a cool record store. I've been to both of them in America. And yeah, I can really get lost in there for a few hours. So yeah, it's a shame that I can't be there right now, actually doing it in the flesh. And I can't wait to see the new Amoeba when we do get a chance to go back to America. But let's get this started. First off, I'm going with one of my favorite records ever, my favorite band. Come together right now. This is the Beatles and Abbey Road. This is an original first week pressing in the UK on Apple. Yeah, what an incredible band. I've been lucky to spend a bit of time at Abbey Road over the last couple of years, and just such an incredible place. It's got history coming out of every single nook and cranny in it. And just as bands go, they're just the best. I mean, they started everything, and you know, they're still as relevant now as they were back then. When I'm on tour, a lot of the time I like to go digging for like originals of their records and spend a lot of time going through loads of dusty places trying to find really odd ones. But I'll always call my dad, because my dad's a complete Beatlehead, and you know, we always listened to that growing up, and there was always records spinning, and you know, he seems to be a bit of an encyclopedia for them of, you know, what's rare and what's worth a lot and what's not. So yeah, when we're on tour, especially in America, like, he'll be, you know, going to bed and I'll be waking up, and you know, I'll be on the phone to him, and that's such a super cool thing for, you know, me to be able to do, to stay in contact when I'm at home. So yeah, that's my first choice, Abbey Road by the Beatles. Second up, another incredible record by another British band. We've got What's the Story in Morning Glory by Oasis. No, yeah, such an amazing, amazing band. And this record, I just feel like it's perfect. The track listing is absolutely ridiculous. It's just absolute banger after banger after banger. Liam and Noel are absolute geniuses, but I mean, Wonderwall, you know, I listened to it recently, and you know, I know it's one of those like karaoke songs and everybody knows it, but actually when you listen to it, it's so genius. Such an amazing song. Roll With It, Don't Look Back in Anger. All of them on one record is absolutely insane. But I love this so much. And yeah, we played a couple of festivals with Liam a few summers ago. Yeah, I'm lucky enough to, you know, quickly meet him, and actually was going for a piss next to him, and we had a little bit of a chat, which was really cool. My friend Craig, that plays drums with Straven and Parfus, stood next to me. He was like, I'm so glad I was here for that, because otherwise no one would fucking believe you. Up after them, sticking with the English vibe, I've gone for Black Sabbath, Paranoid. I mean, just what an incredible band, so influential with metal and the metal community. And just Ozzy's just a genius. I just watched that new documentary that came out about him, and just such a genius, just born to do it. Coming from a working class background and giving it everything he's got, and that's all he wants to do with his life, is play shows, which is absolutely incredible. And yeah, this is another one. I think I found this in a place in Seattle, actually, when I was looking around, going around with our photographer, Ed. And yeah, I've got a newer version of this one, but I just love this old version, just beat up, and I think it was like $8 or something. But yeah, you can't beat an original. Up after that, we have one of my favorite records ever by a band called the Xcerts, called There Is Only You. It's just a genius record. They're from Aberdeen. Murray is the front man, who's also one of my best friends, and I can't tell you how incredible this record is. Everybody that I've showed this to has been blown away. I'd say if you're a fan of Brand New, Teenage Wrist, Biffy Clyro, you should definitely check this out. Incredible lyrics, incredible hooks, just a genius band. And this record reminds me of some seriously good times, getting really drunk together and drunk with all of us. And there's a real connection between Architects and the Xcerts, and we've spent so many years being friends together. Me and Murray went to college together, but yeah, every time I hear this, I'm just stunned at how brilliant it is. So yeah, you need to check this record out. This record was my record of the year last year. It's Phoebe Bridgers' Punisher. I was late to the Phoebe party, not for any reason other than just I hadn't listened to her. And my friend sent me this record and I'm just completely obsessed. I love it. She's got the best voice. She's got so much feeling in her voice and her lyrics are fantastic. And just as a person, I think she comes across as really genuine and really lovely. And I think, I think she's going to be like one of these, this our generation's like Bob Dylan. I think it will be like when, you know, our kids are listening to like Punisher, it'll be like, oh yeah, I was around when that record came out. And I'm honestly such a big fan of her. And yeah, she seems like a super cool person. Up after that, I've got another one of my favorites, Bob Dylan. The answer is blowing in the wind. Again, I was pretty late with Bob Dylan. Only in the last sort of 2 years have I really sort of become completely obsessed with him, but I just love his attitude. I love his songwriting. And he seems to be still putting out great records. The record he released last year was absolutely incredible. With a super long track. It was the first song he released. It's absolutely incredible. And yeah, you just can't beat him. You just can't beat him. And I think, yeah, we're lucky to be in a time when he's around. And for my last choice, I've gone for a book by Linda McCartney, Life in Photographs. And it's amazing. Amazing insight into the McCartney family and their lifestyle, but then also just the incredible photography that she did. I mean, you've got amazing photos, Frank Zappa, Grateful Dead. It's just insane. She's clearly just a really wonderful woman. They were friends with so many people and just got to take those amazing behind the scenes photos when people aren't trying to look as cool as possible. You know, she really got down to the real person. And yeah, I got this book from my friend Ben, plays drums in Royal Blood, and he was also like pretty amazed at it. So I definitely recommend it for people that aren't even massive Beatles heads. It's just some amazing, amazing photography. Thank you so much for tuning in, and thank you so much for watching What's In My Bag. I've had so much fun doing it. I can't wait to be back in Amoeba. But yeah, our record, for those that wish to exist, go get it. We're super proud of this record. There's some amazing colorways. And be super grateful if you checked it out. Thanks so much. I've been Sam from Architects.